What do you think about the luggage pile?
It's a mountain. It's a small mountain.
Last week we moved out of Rontu. Said goodbye, packed up our lives in 18 suitcases, and flew to Sweden.
We made it!
The day after we had come home was Midsummer, a Swedish celebration of summer solstice. We met our families and celebrated with food and the midsummer pole.
We're out on a small road trip today, looking for our future boat. Yeah, we're in a small harbor called Ålabjudarna, and this harbor is quite exposed, especially when the winds are from the southwest. I actually used to have my first boat here on the other side. Almost 25 years ago. We used to go out here at winter time to practice sailing. So we used to come here after work, Tuesdays and Thursdays, if I'm remembering correctly, and then we used to sail around the island of Ven out there, come back here, very cold. I remember some of those sails. We had ice on the railing. Yeah, like most of the small villages along this coast, this is also an old fishing village. And Ålabjudarna actually means eel shed, something like that. So they used to fish a lot of eel out here. Nowadays I think eel is red listed, so I'm not sure if they still do that, at least not commercially. But there are still some commercial fishing boats here.
Summer diet, hot dogs and ice cream.
We'd been lucky to get to borrow an apartment in Malmö from a couple of followers. Thank you so much, Helena and Jens.
Welcome to our third home in a month. This is where we will stay for the coming next 4 weeks. Vera is at the playground with grandma, and we have some time and wanted to update you guys on our plans, and we have some news.
Yeah, pretty big news actually. Yeah. So.
So if we rewind the tape a little bit, back to a few weeks after that we sold Round 2, we got some bad news about one of our family members. And that made us think about our life situation and kind of led us up to the decision that we want to be close to this family member right now, which means that we're going to be in Sweden.
Yeah.
And this was so big and not an easy decision at all, since, you know, we are so used to having our cruising life. We've been cruising and traveling for the last 6.5 years.
Yeah.
But we felt like this is the right thing to do right now.
So I have always had a dream to build my own boat. And this is actually something that we've been having in our future plans that we wanted to do sometime in the future. So what we're doing now is that, we're taking these plans till today. So we will build our own boat starting now here in Sweden. So this is, of course, a major undertaking. It will be it's a lot of work to build your own boat. And what I mean with building our own boat, I actually mean that we're going to build it, not somebody else. And we're also going to be part of the design process, taking all our ideas and thoughts that we've been having over the years, cruising and sailing, and try to put that into this future boat that will be our dream boat.
Try to make it our dream boat.
Yeah. And of course we will have help with a naval designer, naval architect, so everything will be correct. But then we're going to build it ourselves. So.
And then the next thing was, where we're going to build it. Where we're going to do that. So since we got back to Sweden, we've actually been to several showings. More precisely our farms, because we would like to live at the same place where we could build the boat. So we've been looking for a barn, machine shop with a connecting house, so the boat can be built inside there. And it has not been easy to find this barn or place big enough where we can build the boat, and also then when it's ready to get it out.
No, and because it's so important to also to have the right infrastructure surrounding a big project like this, because otherwise the outcome won't be very good. Mm-hmm. So, like Moni said, it's not easy to find the correct place, and we haven't found the right one. We have put a couple of bids on different places, but we haven't won any of them yet. So we'll see where we're going to end up, but
we can show you some of the farms that we went to look at.
Yeah,
they come here.
All of the farms we looked at are from the late 1800s. There's a lot of history and beautiful detail from the era. This farm had a big interest due to its location, but the barn was not in the condition to build a boat in.
And goes all the way down to that stone wall down there.
The one furthest away.
big enough to build a boat in. A beautiful house and surroundings. This farm ticked a lot of boxes.
I have a second place for today. This place does look just good as the last one. This is not the place for us.
Yeah, and as you could see, they looked really nice. One was that we really liked, but we lost it to a secret bid. That's people do here in Sweden. And then we put an offer on another one, the first one that we went to see, but we kind of came to the conclusion that it wasn't the right barn.
It was a good barn, but the problem was that once the boat was ready inside the barn, it was going to be a major problem to get the boat out of there. And pretty costly to alter the house or the barn for that, so we decided to skip that one.
Yeah, we've been, you know, thinking so much now about all these things and trying to, you know, have to have everything, or a lot at least, already decided before you start. Yeah. So it will be the right way to do it, so it won't get stuck or come into problems because of that later on. Because it's such a major project, and financially as well.
Yeah.
So there's a lot of things that has to be right.
Yeah, definitely.
But we're going to look at a farm in a few days, and it looks very promising. It so does. Keep your fingers crossed for us. But we have already starting sketching on the boat, and we were actually got in contact with a naval architect that Johan found.
Yeah.
So that's super promising. And then are you thinking, like, are you not going to sail anymore during the time that you're going to build the boat?
Yeah.
Yes, we are. Of course we are. Like, that's what the first thing we said. Like, if we're going to stay now in Sweden, we have to continue sailing. We cannot live without sailing.
No. So we have actually already bought another boat that we will use here in our home waters in the neighboring countries for some cruising.
Yeah. Johan found a boat on like Craigslist, the Swedish version Blocket. A few days ago, he went up there while I was working and he bought it. So I hadn't even seen it, just like two photos online.
No. So today I'm on my way to have a look at what might be our future boat. It's a lot smaller than our last one, but I think it will be a good match for us during the time when we're building our next boat. So Malin is not with me today. She's been giving me free hands to have a look at this boat myself. From the ad, it looks like it might be a good fit for us, this boat. It's a classic boat. It's from 1968, but it's in glass fiber. It's Harmony 31, so 9.5 meters. Yeah, everything is moving along pretty quickly right now. I mean, we've only been home for a bit over 2 weeks, and we have already bought a car, and now maybe we're buying a boat, and we actually have put two bids on two different farms. So this place is called Åhus. It's a pretty small town on the east coast of Skåne. And it was a long time since I was here, but if I remember correctly, the marina is alongside the small river down here. Pretty cozy place. Och så får man köra en sån. So we have our new boat. I just paid him $5,700. Good price, I think. A lot of boat for the money.
We have a boat.
What? So that's all the news, and we're super excited. Yeah. Even because of this, you know, hard decision to take and the circumstances. Yeah. But we hope you are excited as well, and we want you want to join on us on this really new adventure. Yeah. And we're going to take you through the whole process.
Yeah, the whole process, designing the boat and our thoughts around the perfect long distance sailing boat, and yeah, the thoughts about all of our different ideas and yeah, the whole design process, and then of course the whole build and where we're going to build it and the infrastructure surrounding that. So it's going to be a lot of different stuff, and we're probably also going to visit a lot of shipyards to get some
inspiration.
Yeah. And
we would love to invite people to come and help us.
Yeah, of course.
Because it would be great with help.
We're going to need all the help we can get, of course. So I have a background as a cabinet maker, like a carpenter making furniture. So I have no real background building boats, but I have some background from woodworking. So prepare for lots of sailing in our home waters, fixing up our new old boat, small boats, and lots of boat building in our future videos.
We're on the road again, heading to northeast Skåne, where we're going to. I'm going to see our new boat for the first time, and Vera as well. Haven't seen her yet, so that's really exciting. Ska det bli kul att se vår nya båt? This is our new little boat. Cute. Hi, Bonnie.
That is Lars.
Yeah. Hey,
hey. Hey. How are you? Good.
How do you feel?
Well, I feel great. I think this is I'm so happy that you're going to take over this boat. I think it's marvelous, really. It's the best thing that could happen to her.
That's great. Yeah. We're also happy.
Feels really good that you feel that way.
Yes. And it's going to be so exciting to watch what's going to happen to her in the future.
Yeah.
So that's an additional perk, I think.
Yeah, we will take care of her for sure.
And you're welcome.
Well, you better. Yes. You better, because I'm really in love with this boat, and I wish her the best for the... she's going to have the sort of fourth life now, I think.
Yeah. And you're welcome to join us whenever you want.
Oh, that's
and come and visit.
Yes.
This can be my berth. I fit. So we have now said goodbye to Lars. It's exciting. She needs a little bit of TLC, tender love and care. But I kind of like the idea of now just have this boat and keep it more simple. She's more inexpensive in maintenance and everything, and also for marina cost and insurance. So it would be a great little boat to come and visit and go out with for a couple of days. So let's hope that we get some good weather soon so we can go out for the first little sail. Because we're not far from the archipelago on the southeast coast of Sweden called Blekinge, where we sailed 2 years ago. And also there are some little small islets just north of Aarhus, which is only a few nautical miles away.
We had a look around the boat, and don't worry, we will give you the full tour soon. Actually, already in next week's episode, so stay tuned. Thank you for watching, and we hope you want to continue to follow our adventures.